Today we're going to talk first about depression. Remember in our last study we talked about Christians facing suffering and looked particularly at 2 Corinthians chapter 1. But today we're going to talk about the most common of all emotional difficulties, which is depression. Depression is most commonly caused by loss. It can be a real loss, it can be a perceived loss. So a death in the family is a common cause of depression. But so might be a sense of your youth passing. I remember when I turned 40 that I felt depressed for a while because I felt like everything I'm going to do, I've done. And now from here on, I just repeat the same things over and over and over till I die, which of course wasn't true, but that's what it felt like then. That was perceived loss. A loss like a job or children all moving out. Things like that can just leave an emotional valley that we move into. Typically with that kind of depression, you go into it, takes a while, and gradually you come out of it, depending on what caused it, how long it lasts. Sometimes, if you're depressed, say there is a death of a loved one, but then immediately you have to take care of someone else, and you can't really grieve, you can't really let this process. It's like hitting a wall, and someday when that wall comes down, you still have to go through that valley. People can't just suppress depression very easily. And so sometimes it seems as though there is no reason for the depression because there's been such a long interruption, such a long space from when the loss happened. When we're depressed, one of the things that's confusing is that part of your brain tells you the truth. It might tell you the truth about, you know, you're going to get through this, or God is not going to let you down, or you're strong. But the other part of your brain seems to be saying, everything is awful. I just feel terrible. Everything is dark. And this side of your brain makes more sense to you. It's more real to you than the other side. And that's the struggle of depression. There's a sort of understanding in the back of your mind that this isn't really true. I'm not thinking well. But the part that isn't thinking well is at the front, and that's the hard part of depression. So people will come to the pastor or a counselor and say, I know I shouldn't feel this way, or I know I should trust God more, but it's just difficult for them. Depression not only is caused by loss, but it can also be caused by anger or hurt or frustration that's turned inward. Some people, when they get angry, have outbursts. They explode. If they're frustrated, everybody knows it. That's not good, but it doesn't go in. It's not a healthy way to handle anger. The Bible teaches us ways to handle our anger, but at least it's not going in to the emotions, it's going out. But if we feel like we cannot let our anger out and we don't have biblical ways to deal with it, it turns in, that frustration turns in. And if there's a lot of anger or a lot of hurt, that anger starts to produce a kind of sense of wanting revenge. But you can't get revenge. You can't do anything. That can come out, as you can see in the chart we're showing you, in different ways. It can come out in destructive action. You start breaking things. You run away. The guy jumps in his car, and the next time you hear from him is 3 days later. You might just let the anger out. Another way it comes out is sort of a passive aggressiveness. So there is this quietness, whatever you want, and then there is ways that we undercut what's happening, that we say one thing but do another, that we signal all is well, but we also are biting at people underneath the surface. And so we're sending these two messages. And that's another way. Another product of anger turned in is your body starts to break down. It's a psychosomatic illness. There isn't perhaps anything actually wrong with your body, but you start to have headaches, or you can't sleep, or you ache. You might get sick to your stomach. So there are things that happen, and if it goes on long enough, these things become real physical problems, because the body then is bearing the weight of this depression and anger. And of course, it can just lead to ongoing depression, just a slow mood. Some depression, so we've said some depression is, the typical cause is loss, real or perceived. Some depression is caused by anger turned inward, or frustration, or hurt, like someone who's been a victim of something. And so they feel that they can't talk. Remember the example we had a few lectures ago of the woman who had been abused as a child, and then she starts getting angry with her husband. I knew a case like that years ago. I had a friend. We were actually in seminary together. He was a cheerful guy, but he and his wife lived in a second floor apartment. And when the music downstairs was a little too loud, it didn't bother his wife. It wasn't that loud, but he went into a rage. And he knew something was wrong. This wasn't a right reaction. There was something out of balance. So first he went to his pastor, and then the pastor referred him to a counselor, a Christian counselor. As they began to talk, it came out that he had been hurt badly by his mother, and he had to deal with this anger. He told me once he felt like he was in a long tunnel, black tunnel, and he had to get through this. And then he said, but now I can see a little bit of a light. And gradually he worked with this counselor to forgive her and to kind of let go of those influences. Here's a strange thing that happened. My friend sang in a small group that I directed. When he sang, he was a tenor. He had a higher voice. After this all happened, his voice dropped and he became a bass, because the tension in his body relaxed. Isn't that amazing? So depression can come from this anger turned inward. Another cause of depression can be just mental illness. There can be something wrong in the body, in the brain. We call it clinical depression. The tip-off that someone's depression is chemical is that it never goes away. Other kinds of depressions kind of have this sort of a quality. They might be depressed for a period of time, but they weren't depressed before. Some might be depressed for the winter, but then it picks up and they feel better in the summer. That's not mental illness. That's what we call situational depression. But mental illness typically, I'm not sure if it's always true, but typically has a kind of flat depression, because it's caused by something wrong in the body, and that doesn't go away. It doesn't change. Depression like that might come, a common one is postpartum depression after the birth of a baby. Sometimes there's just changes in the body for various reasons, an illness, medication, and then there is a depression that just is relentless. It never lets go. There's a remarkable book that I've read by a woman named Catherine Green McCrate. She had 3 degrees. She's a very smart lady. She had 3 degrees from Yale, including a PhD. And also she was a minister in a church. She's a believer. And she went after the birth of a baby into a terrible postpartum depression. Later, that depression sort of changed into bipolar disorder, highs and lows. And there was nothing she could do. She tried medication and she was even hospitalized. Her husband was very supportive. And she writes about this eloquently to help us understand what it was like to go through this. She says, "How is the soul affected by the disease of the mind, indeed of the brain? If your mind, your brain is diseased, what does that do to your soul? Think about that." She said, "Depression is not just sadness or sorrow. In serious depression, it is being cast to the very end of your tether and then dropped. It's a terrible feeling."
Have you benefited from our teaching ministry? Have you found TVS videos helpful and relevant? Please consider supporting us with your prayers and financial gifts. For more information, visit tvsseminary.com.
Well, depression, in one sense, is always a spiritual issue. No matter what causes it, it affects you spiritually. The cause could be directly spiritual. We've talked about other causes. Sometimes a cause is directly spiritual. It doesn't necessarily mean your depression is a sin, but that's one cause. David said, when he was guilty, when he was burdened by guilt, "When I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long." That's a depressed man. And it was caused by his sin and his unwillingness at first to confess his sin. But think of Elijah when in his spiritual exhaustion, when he ran away and hid, he was depressed and he hadn't done anything wrong. So depression isn't always caused by failure. In his case, it was a sign of spiritual exhaustion. Or look at Psalm 88. I suggest you go and read Psalm 88. It is a dark psalm. It has no hope in it. It says, "But I cry to you for help, Lord. In the morning, my prayer comes before you. Why, Lord, do you reject me and hide your face from me? From my youth, I have suffered and been close to death, for I have borne your terrors and am in despair. Your wrath has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me. All day long, they surround me like a flood. They have completely engulfed me. You have taken from me my friend and my neighbor. Darkness is my closest friend." And there it ends. That's the darkest psalm in the Bible. And that is how some people feel. A friend of mine read this in a worship service one Sunday in his sermon. It was just part of his sermon. Afterwards, a man came up and said, "I want to accept Christ. I didn't know the Bible would say something like that. And that is how I feel. And if God understands that, I want to accept Christ." Isn't that amazing? As I've mentioned before, I've had occasional bouts of depression myself. And I can tell you what I mentioned before, that the way I put it is depression has its own logic. What I was saying before, what part of your brain is telling you one thing and another part of your brain is telling you something else. And it's really hard to overcome the logic of depression, even when people are telling you it's not really this way. One thing that I remember helping me when it was the darkest was I remembered a phrase I'd heard somewhere, I don't know where. It was, "Never doubt in the darkness what you knew to be true in the light." Never doubt in the darkness what you knew to be true in the light. In our next session, we're going to talk about some signs of depression and a few more things to help you recognize and treat it.